This time, let's try to understand what are the different laws that govern each connection. So let's start with the series circuit again. Let's say we have a simple series circuit with an applied voltage. So let's place a battery here that is worth 10 volts. Okay, let's connect this to 3 resistors, which are all connected in series. O, diba? Gising na yung manok. Okay. Let's say this resistor is rated 2 ohms. This one is 5 ohms. And the other one is 3 ohms. Okay. So this is a simple series connection of 3 resistors with 1 impressed or applied voltage. Number 1 governing law of a series circuit is that the total current that flows through the circuit is simply equivalent to the current in each resistor. So, what we're going to do is, let's say this is resistor 1. This one is your resistor 2. And let's say this one is your resistor 3. Since all the components run into the same wire, iisang linya, iisang wire, kung saan nakakabit. Sa resistor 1, resistor 2, resistor 3, ibig sabihin, iisa lang dapat ang kuryenteng dadaloy dyan. Thus, the first principle. So, for ease of representation, bawat isang resistor, nilalagyan natin ng direction of flow of current. And based on our current flow notation, from the positive terminal of the voltage, dun manggagaling yung current natin. So, current will flow from the positive terminal all the way, all throughout the circuit until it goes back to the supply. And it will continuously flow in that manner. Therefore, pag lumabas yung kuryente dito, may dadaan na current kay 2 ohms or kay resistor 1, iikot yan. Yung current na dadaan kay resistor 2 will be in this manner because we are following a clockwise rotation. And then you'll have another current representation or another arrow that would represent the current that flows through the third resistor or resistor 3. So as you can see, clockwise lang. Nilagyan lang natin ng tigigisang arrow ang bawat resistor for representation. So, for representation, this will be I1 because it is the current that flows through R1. This one would be I2, the current that flows through R2. And this one would be I3, the current that flows through R3. All in all, we have a total current that flows or that is supplied by the voltage or that is pushed by the voltage. So, you have a current that comes from the voltage source all through the circuit, and this will represent the total current na umiikot doon sa circuit natin. But since iisa yung linya, diba? Kung ano man daw yung total current na ibinigay ng voltage mo at series yung line na yan, yun din ang kuryenteng dadaan kay resistor 2 kasi nakasiris siya. Yun din ang magnitude or value ng current na dadaan kay resistor 2, at yun din ang value ng current ni resistor 3, which is I3. Number 2. For us to get the total resistance of a series connected line or a series connected circuit, that is simply the algebraic sum of all the resistances that are connected in series only. So, kahit ilan pa yan. Kaya nakalagay dyan R1, plus R2, plus R3, and so on. Depende sa kung gaano ba karami yung resistor na nakakabit in series. So, in this example of our circuit, this has 1, 2, 3 resistors connected in series. Thus, the formula will simply be R1 plus R2 plus R3. For our third principle, the impressed voltage, impressed or applied voltage, ito yon si 10 volts, yung voltage na isinupply natin para mag-power dun sa circuit natin, which may be represented as E, or it could be represented by V total. Okay? The impressed voltage daw po, or the total voltage applied in the circuit, is simply equivalent to the sum of all the voltage drops in every resistance in the circuit. So, syempre, when current flows through the resistor, you have I here and resistance, ibig sabihin kakain to ng energy, thus there will be voltage drop. Pag dumaan ulit yung current and on the 5 ohm resistor naman, meron din siyang voltage drop. And ito, meron din siyang voltage drop. So, para makuha mo, by principle of series circuits, kung ano man daw yung applied voltage natin, or yung supply or source voltage natin, 10 volts yun, dapat pag pinagsama-sama natin yung voltage drops ng tatlong resistance na yan, nakakonect ng series, dapat 10 volts din ang sum nila. Thus, to represent the voltage drops, that would be V1, voltage drop in the first resistor, plus V2, voltage drop in the second resistor, plus V3, voltage drop in the third resistor, and so on, depending on how many resistances are connected in series to the circuit. For our fourth principle, yung total power daw po that is dissipated in the circuit or that is supplied to the circuit is simply equivalent to the summation of the power absorbed by each of the resistances connected in series also. So that will simply be power absorbed by resistor 1, i-add lang natin siya with power absorbed by resistor 2, i-add lang natin siya to the power absorbed by resistor 3, and so on. Depende sa ano ba karami yung resistances na nakakabit dun sa circuit natin. And if you can recall from our previous topics, di ba, na nag-start tayo ng introduction to electricity, we already know that power is additive. We simply add power consumption of our appliances at home. So, this four laws will guide us while understanding or in understanding series circuits. So, how do we prove this laws? So, take for example again this illustrative series circuit that we have using equation number 2, getting the total resistance of the circuit. Diba kasi as you can see, yung 10 volts natin dito, that would be your VT, total voltage applied. Pwede nating kuhanin muna yung total resistance ng circuit natin. And that would be RT equal to, pag-aadin lang daw yung mga resistances na nakakabit ng series. So you have 2 ohms plus 5 ohms plus 3 ohms. So in total, you have 10 ohm resistance. Kung meron kang applied total voltage at nakuha mo yung total resistance of the circuit, going back to Ohm's law, that would be I equal to V over R, pwede nating makompute yung total current that flows through the circuit. So, if I'm solving for I total, this voltage should be the total voltage and this resistance should be the total resistance. So, if we substitute, what is our total voltage? That is 10 volts. Divided by our total resistance, that's also 10. So, 10 divided 10, that gives us 1. And this is current, so we get 1 ampere for our total current. When you go to the first principle, sabi dito, kung ano daw yung total current flowing through the circuit, that would be the same current that flows through each resistances. Which means, if IT is 1 ampere, then I1, I2, and I3 will also be equivalent to 1 ampere. If we solve for voltage drops, kasi meron na tayong current sa bawat resistor, so 1 ampere to 2 ohms yun, 1 ampere to 5 ohms yun, 1 ampere to 3 ohms yun. Pwede natin kunin yung voltage drop in each resistances, di ba? Going back to this principle of Ohm's law, to get voltage, we multiply resistance to I. So, ibig sabihin, ang V mo equal to IR. But since we're solving for voltage drops, hindi na tayo mag-VT dito, total voltage yun eh. So, kung kunin natin ang voltage drop na resistor 1, ibig sabihin, current sa resistor 1 ang kailangan natin. So, ano ba yung current sa resistor 1? That is 1 ampere times value ni resistor 1, that's 2 ohms. So you have 2 volts voltage drop at the resistor 1. For V2, same formula, that's IR. Pero in this case, current 2 naman, tsaka resistance 2. So, current 2 is 1 ampere ulit. Multiply that to resistance 2, which is 5 ohms. Ibig sabihin, you have there 5 volts for the voltage drop. For V3, same process, that would be R3. I3 is still 1 ampere. And R3 is 3 ohms. And that gives you 3 volts. To check, to validate our answers, you have here the third governing law, which shows na kapag inad mo daw yung voltage drops ng bawat resistances natin, dapat mag-equate siya dun sa applied voltage mo sa circuit. And as you can see, if you take here V1 plus V2 plus V3, that would be 2 plus 5 plus 3, which is still 10 volts. And 10 volts is indeed your total applied voltage. For the fourth law naman, in terms of power, let me erase this for space. Okay. So, sabi dun sa principle natin, for you to get total power, you should take the sum of power absorbed by each resistor connected in series. So, in this circuit, yung total power natin will be the power absorbed by resistor 1, power absorbed by resistor 2, and power absorbed by resistor 3. But before that, if we can recall, we have 3 versions of formulas for power. You have power equal to current times voltage. You have power equivalent to I squared R. And you have power equivalent to V squared over R. In this case, kahit alin pwede mong gamitin, depende sa kung anong available dun sa circuit mo. If you want to try, we can solve for P1. I'll use this formula. Ibig sabihin, kung power ni resistor 1 ang kailangan ko, dapat current ni resistor 1 times voltage ni resistor 1. Thus, ano bang current natin? That's 1 ampere. Ano ba ang voltage ni resistor 1? Balik tayo dito. That's 2 volts. 2 times 1, you get 2. Power would be in watts. Pwede mo naman kunin yung power ni resistor 1 using this formula naman. I squared R. So, kung power ni resistor 1 to, dapat I1 ito. Pero i-square mo yan. Times resistance 1. So, current natin is 1 ampere. Quantity squared ulit. Resistance 1 natin is 2 ohms. So, 1 squared is 1 times 2. 2 pa din. Unit watts, kasi power yan. Kung gusto mo namang isolve si power 1 using V squared over R, you have here V squared over R. But since power of resistor 1 yan, dapat V1 squared yan, voltage absorbed ni resistor 1, divided by resistor 1. So V1, going back, is 2 volts quantity squared, divided by resistor 1 is 2 ohms. Thus, you get 4 divided 2. Still have 2 watts. So, kahit alin, dun sa formula natin with power, depende sa kung anong given sa circuit nyo, or depende sa kung anong given sa problem nyo, you can use to solve for power. It will give you the same answer. Ngayon, since P1 is already 2 watts, let me try solving for the power of the remaining resistances. So, I'll erase this. Let's say for P2, I use the same formula. So, we have I2, V2. Current in resistor 2, that is still 1 ampere, times voltage at resistor 2, and that is 5 volts. So, 1 times 5, you get 5 watts. For power of resistor 3, you have I3, V3. Current at resistor 3, that is 1 ampere. Diba? Pare-parehas yung current natin. Times voltage at resistor 3, that is 3 volts. And that gives you 3 watts. Therefore, to solve for P total, based on this formula, we simply add P1, P2, and P3. And that gives you 10 watts of total power. For an alternative solution on total power, since meron ka naman ganito, di ba? Pwede mo naman gawing diretso PT na. If you're going to use IV, ibig sabihin, total current dapat ito. And V should be total voltage. What again is our total power? Total current? total current is the same, that's 1 ampere. Multiply it to the total voltage. Total voltage is the applied voltage, 10 volts. 1 times 10, that still gives you 10 watts of power. So, kahit alin dito, sa dalawang to, you can use to solve for power total. Magiging ano lang to. PT is equivalent to I total squared R total. Or, PT is equal to V total squared over R total.